Hi, hello, good evening. I am Dr. E. Raju. Welcome to my YouTube channel. First, I would like to wish to all a happy, prosperous, healthy, and a safe New Year 2022. Friends, this is the first video I am uploading in 2022 into my YouTube channel. Many students asked me how to get a Linux environment in Windows without installing Linux operating system. Let's get started. So friends, in this video, we'll talk about how to execute Linux commands in Windows operating system. That means without installing Linux operating system, how we can get the feel of executing commands on a Linux command line. So friends, I will demonstrate you with minimal software installation how we can get that Linux command prompt into our Windows machine. So you want to execute Linux commands mkdir command to create a directory which we use in Linux bash shell for creating a directory. So the same you want to perform in Windows operating system, and similarly a command like cd command like pw present working directory, and a command like gcc, especially those who want to get the experience of a Linux command prompt in Windows and execute their C programs comfortably by using this GCC command. So all I demonstrate in this video, friends, don't worry. With the minimal software, you can get the feeling of working on a Linux command prompt. So there are other commands also you can work out using this minimal software. LS command you can work out, copy command, cat command, and move command. Okay, so all Linux commands you can work out with the installation of these minimal software. Okay, so let us see what are the softwares required to get Linux command prompt feed. So that means we require two softwares, friends. The first one is Git bash software we require, and the second one is MinGW software. Okay, so with these two applications, we can get our Linux command prompt into our Windows machine. Okay, so friends, let us see how to download and install these two softwares, and afterwards I'll show you how to execute all those commands using these two softwares. Okay, so that means you get a feel of working on a Linux command prompt. Okay, so let's get started. So first, open your browser. Friends, open your browser. In browser, in Google, you type git bash download. Git bash download. Then you will redirect it to git-scm.com, their official website. Okay, so downloads Git. Okay, so click on this link, downloads Git. Then their Git homepage, you will be redirected to their Git homepage. Okay, so here you can see download for Windows. Okay, so this is the latest version of Git software, and just click on this download for Windows. Then here you can see if your machine is 32-bit machine, you can download 32-bit Git for a Windows setup. And if your machine is 64-bit Git, 64-bit machine, you can download 64-bit Git for a Windows setup. Okay. So how to know whether our machine is 32-bit or 64-bit machine? Okay. So for this, friends, I am just showing here how to know that. So on your PC, go to your My Computer or this PC, right click on this PC, then go to Properties, then here you can see System Type, 64-bit operating system, x64 based processor. Okay, so 4GB RAM and Windows 8 operating system. So by this you can confirm whether your machine is 32-bit machine or 64-bit machine. Okay, accordingly you download the required Git software. Okay, so since my machine is 64-bit machine, so I am downloading 64-bit Git for a Windows setup. Okay, so click on this. Otherwise, there is a click here to download. You can see here. Okay, so just click on this. Click here to download. Now, the latest version of Git will be downloaded here. Okay, so 64-bit, by default, it is 64-bit version of Git for Windows. Okay, so it is being downloaded here, just you can see. Okay. Yes. Okay, so once downloaded, just click on this exe file. .exe file will be downloaded, friends. Okay, so click on this .exe file. Then it starts installing Git for Windows onto your machine. Okay, so just click yes. Now GNU General Public License, you need to accept here. Okay, so just scroll down here. Scroll down, scroll down. Okay, so yeah, so directly there is a next button. So that means you are accepting this. Click on the next button. And this is the default folder where this JIT will be installed. C program files and JIT. In that folder, the software will be installed. Okay, so let it be as it is. Don't make any change in this. Okay, so let the default folder available for installation of this JIT. Okay, so click on next here. Okay, so since I have already installed, now it is asking the folder already exists. Would you like to install? Okay, so I click on yes. Okay, now these are all the options available. Just check this first option, friends, additional icons. Okay, so you want this JIT bash icon on your desktop. Okay, so just click on this first checkbox. Okay, so check it, then click on next here. Now setup will create a shortcut called as JIT. Okay, so click on next here. Okay, so just click on next here. But here you need to understand the default editor is VI editor. Okay, so in Linux you might have worked on a gedit or a nano editor, but here the default editor available is VI editor. I will show you how to open that editor after installing the software. Okay, so just click on next here. Okay, so click on next here. Here you select this third one, use JIT on the optional Unix tools from command prompt. Okay, then click on next. Use the OpenSSL library, let it be selected, click on next. Now check out Windows style, commit Unix style line endings. Okay, so just click on next. again minimal terminal type, use minimal terminal type. Okay, so let it be, let the box be checked and click on next and default. Okay, click on next and click on next. So enable file system caching. Okay, so just click on next here. Okay, so don't check these two boxes, let it be empty. Okay, so now you click on install, let your Git software installs into your Windows machine. Now the software is being installed, Git 2.3.34.1 version. 2.34.1 version. This is the latest version of Git that is being installed into your system. Wait until the software is installed into your system. Yes. So running post install script. Yes. Now the software installed successfully, completing the Git setup software. Okay. So you can just check here. Launch Git bash. Okay, so we want a Git bash and click on finish. How do you want to open this type of a file, HTML? Okay, so just you can click on Microsoft Edge so that the documentation about Git will be available here. Okay, so this you can read afterwards. Release notes, this is called as. Okay, so that will be displayed in your browser. Okay, so let us go to the command prompt. Okay, so this is the command prompt that is opened for you. Okay, now you can see the command prompt, friends, here. Okay, so the dollar prompt is opened for you. Now here you can start executing your Linux commands. Okay, so let me increase the size of this. So new command prompt, just let me check out. Any options available here? Yeah, options, let me go to options. Okay, so right click on this header bar. Okay, so then here you can just check out text here. Okay, so font, you can select the font, you can increase the font size. Okay, so it is 10. What I do is I make it 16 and just click on apply, then apply, save. Okay, so you can see the dollar prompt here. Okay, so size of this font is 16. Okay, so still you want to increase the size of this dollar prompt. Okay, so right click on this, go to place your cursor. Okay, arrow on this bar here, right click, options, go to options. Okay, so here you select text here. Okay, then font you select here, and size you can increase here, 18, 20, you can select any one which you want. So click on apply, then save. Okay, so now this is our bash shell. Dollar prompt means bash shell. Okay, so we in Linux, you might have executed commands at a bash shell. Okay, so that same bash shell is now available in our Windows machine. Okay, so the first thing is, what is our present working directory, that we need to know here. So for that, the command is pwd, present working directory. Now you can see, friends, here. Okay, So in C drive, there is a folder called as users. In that folder with my name in your system with your name. Okay. So this will be the your default working directory. Default working directory. Okay. So if you want to create a new folder. Okay. So then you can use a command called as mkdir, make directory. Make directory. Okay. See, I want to execute C programs especially. Okay. So what I do is, friends, I create a folder, or in Linux we call them as directories. Okay. So I create a directory with the name called as C programs, mkdir C programs. Okay. Now the directory is created. Directory is created. Okay. So to check whether the directory is created or not, what is the command you use? We use the command called as list command, ls. Okay. So here it lists all the subdirectories present in your current working directory. Okay. So in this, you can see a name C programs. This is the directory created. Okay. So this is the name of the directory created. Okay. So now you can move into this directory. You can move into this directory. Just to clear all this, you can type a command called as a clear. Okay. So then all the text on the command prompt will be cleared, and you will get a fresh command prompt on your screen. Okay. So just type clear and everything will be cleared here. Okay. So now you want to move into that directory. What is your present directory? Your present directory is in C users Raju. Okay. So I'll show you what is your present directory in Windows, because we are in Windows system now. Okay. So in Windows, go to your C drive. Okay. In C drive, there is a folder called as users, and in that there is a folder called as Raju, and in that now you can see I have created a folder called as a C programs. Okay. So in Windows, if you create a directory, that will be created as a folder. Okay. So everything will be stored in this folder if you change your present working directory to this C programs. Okay. So now what I do is I move into this C programs directory. Okay. So I want to change my directory. What is the command we use? CD, change directory command, and my folder name is, or my directory name is C programs I want to move into. Okay. So now you can see friends here. Okay. So that means this is your present directory. That means you change it into this directory called as C programs. Okay. So once you executed CD command, then you can see here your current working directory name will be present at the end here. Previously my present working directory was Raju. Okay. So in that, now I have a subdirectory called as C programs, and this is my present working directory. Now you can just execute the command called as pwd, present working directory. Now you can see here. Okay. So C users Raju C programs. This is my present working directory. So in this directory, I have not created any folder. Okay. So just if you type ls command, nothing will be displayed because there are no folders, no files created. That's why your current working directory, C programs directory, will be empty. Okay. So friends, I will show you how to create a file in this. We'll use a command called as vi. We use a command called as a vi. That means the editor which is used to type your program in this Git application is vi editor. Okay. So default editor is vi editor. Okay. So if you try to open this gedit. Okay. So then say, for example, gedit, my file name is first.c. Now you can see bash shell is giving a error that gedit command not found. Okay. So that means this editor is not available along with this software. Okay, so the default editor is VI editor. Okay, so let me clear the screen. Okay, so let me clear the screen. The command to be used is clear. Okay, just you type clear, then all the text will be cleared here. Okay, so friends, I am showing you how to open an editor where you can type your C program. Okay, so the editor name is VI editor. Okay, so here I open my file name because this is my first C program in this environment. Okay, so I call my file name as first.c. okay, so then you click on enter key. Okay, so then this is the blank screen you will get, and which is called as a VI editor. Okay, so now you are in VI editor, friends. And if you type anything here, nothing will be displayed here. Okay, so that means the editor is not able to receive input from your keyboard. Okay, from your keyboard. Now you need to change the mode of this editor into insert mode. Okay, so I will show you. Just let me resize the screen so that you can see here. You can see here at the bottom. At the bottom, you can just see here first.c. okay, so the file name is displayed. Okay, and the cursor is waiting here, and if you type anything, nothing will be entered onto this screen or editor. Okay, so what you need to do is you need to change the mode of the editor into insert mode. Okay, so for this, what you need to do is I'll just type the command. What you need to do is you just press the key I on your keyboard. Letter I is available. Okay, so you need to press that key. If you press that key I here, okay, so you need to press this key I. okay, so I means you are asking the editor to change into insert mode. Change into insert mode. Okay, so I will show you what happens, how the mode of this editor changes into insert mode. Okay, so let us go back to our editor. Okay, so this is our editor. Now what I do is just at the bottom of this editor, you can see here, friends, I am now pressing the key I, either capital I or small I. Okay, so both are applicable here. Okay, so anyone you can use here. So let the key I be pressed here. Okay, so once you press the key I here, you can see at the bottom insert, the word insert is displayed on the editor. Okay, so that means now the editor is changed into insert mode. Now you can type your C program here. Okay, so that means now it is able to take input from your keyboard, and it displays the letters on this editor. Okay, so now I am typing my first program here, hash include stdio.h. okay, so then in the next line, type int main, then begin the main with open curly brace. Okay, so now here what I do is I just print a welcome message, because this is my first program. I just print a welcome message, welcome to C programming. Welcome to C programming. Or you can type, since we are discussing about installation of a JIT bash. Okay, so welcome to installation of installation of zip bash. Then type new line at the end, close with a semicolon. Okay, so then finally the last line returns zero. Okay, so then end your C program here. End your C program here. Okay, so friends, so once you type your C program, once you complete typing your C program, okay, so I will just write some text here. Okay, so how to save your program, what is the command to be used in this VI editor? Okay, so I am just to save the program. Okay, so type, what you need to type is, you need to type colon WQ. You need to type colon WQ and then press enter. Okay, so this is nothing but write and quit. W indicates write. Okay, so that means write means save your file on the hard disk and then quit. Quit means quit this editor. Quit this editor. Okay, so this is the command to be used to save the program. To save your program, this is the command to be used, colon WQ. Okay, so when you type colon WQ, okay, so before this, you need to type, you need to press the escape key once. Okay, so here I'll write clearly to save the program. Okay, so what you need to do is, you need to press the escape key. Okay, so at the left top corner you will have this escape key. Press the escape key and then type, and then type colon WQ. Okay friends, understood? Okay, so first you need to press the escape key once. Escape key once. Okay, so then after you type this command, colon WQ, right and quit. Okay, so here I'm just writing the command what you need to do. Okay, so let me just show here. So that means escape plus means afterwards. Okay, so you need to do colon WQ, you need to type. Okay, so this is the command to be used here, escape colon WQ. Okay, so when you type this command, your program will be saved onto the hard disk and you will quit this editor. Okay, so remember this. So I'm just erasing this from this editor. Now you can see what happens when I type this command. I'm just erasing this text. Okay, so for your understanding purpose, I have just typed here so that you can remember, you can copy in your notebook so that you can practice afterwards. Okay, so on the screen, just friends, see here, I'm just minimizing the yes. Now see here, friends, at the bottom, you can just check out this. Yeah, friends, just see here. Okay, so I'm just showing the cursor here. Okay, so observe the cursor. When you type escape colon WQ, that will be displayed at the bottom here. Okay, so I'm just pressing the key escape once. Okay, so then that insert will be disappeared. Okay, so afterwards shift button, press the shift button and type colon. You can see colon displayed at the bottom of the screen, left bottom of the screen. Okay, so then type WQ, then type WQ. That means once you press this escape key, okay, so then the mode of your editor will change from insert to command mode. Okay, so and when you type this command, when you type this command colon WQ, it will be displayed at the bottom of the screen. Okay. Afterwards, press enter. Afterwards, press enter. Okay. Now your file is saved and you are redirected to your command prompt. Okay. So now you are on the dollar prompt. Now you type ls command. Now you can see your folder, your first.c file is created in your directory, C programs directory. You have created your first file. Okay. So that is first.c. Okay. Now you try to compile this with a GCC command. GCC. Okay. So then first.c. Now just see here, the bash shell has given the error GCC command not found. That means there is no support for this GCC compiler. Okay. So JIT bash has no support for this GCC compiler. Okay. So what you need to do is you need to install another software called as a MinGW. You need to install the second software called as a MinGW. Okay. So if you install this MinGW, the full form of this MinGW is minimal GNU software for Windows. Okay. So that means you are getting a feel of Linux command prompt with minimal software installation on your Windows machine. Okay. So we need to install this application, MinGW application. Then this contains all the compilers like GCC, G++ and Fortran, other compilers and other tools are also available, but we required only GCC compiler. Okay. So to get that GCC compiler, we need to install this MinGW software. Okay. So let us go to our browser. Okay. So open Google. And here you type MinGW download. Now you can see here, friends. Okay. So there is an official website, mingw-w64.org. You can go to their website there. Click on this. Okay. So then click on these three buttons. Okay. Otherwise you can scroll down. And here the list is available. Okay. So what you do is better you go to this downloads folder. Okay. So click on this downloads link. And here you can see the various tools that are available in this. Okay. So here we required the support for a MinGW because my system is 64-bit system. Okay. So MinGW W64 builds. You click on this. Now it asks you the installation. Okay. So MinGW builds installation is available from SourceForge. Okay. So you click on this SourceForge. It will be redirected to SourceForge web page. Now see here, your download will start shortly. Okay. So then your .exe file for MinGW is being installed here. Sorry. Okay. So being downloaded here. Now you can see here MinGW W64 install.exe. Okay. So your installer will be downloaded here. Okay. .exe file. Both are .exe files only, friends. Your Git is also .exe file and MinGW is also .exe file. Okay. So you can see in downloads folder, you know, you can see this is the MinGW install. Okay. So click on this, double click on this. And now the software is being installed. Okay. So click on yes. Welcome to MinGW 64 installation. Okay. So just click on next. Version 8.1.0 is being set up. Okay, so click on next, and the default folder is program files min.gw. Okay, so W64, that is the folder name. Okay, so create a shortcut in start menu. You select this. Okay, so then click on next. Now this starts installing the software into your Windows machine. Okay, so wait until the software is being installed. So it takes some time, friends. It is downloading the file. So it takes 2 to 3 minutes to download the entire file. If you have good internet connection, then it can be downloaded faster. Okay, since I have opened other applications, that's why it is taking longer time to get the file, to download the file. So click on next to continue the installation. Then click finish to complete the installation. So let us verify whether it is being installed correctly or not. Okay. So what we need to do is again go back to your git bash command prompt. Okay, so here you execute the command again, gcc first.c. Okay, so still it is saying that command not found. Okay, so friends, here that means this git bash is unable to locate this gcc application. Okay, so which is available in this min.gw software. Okay, so we need to link these two. Okay, so that means the path we need to set for this GCC application. Okay, so for that, what we need to do is, first let us verify whether it is installed or not. Okay, so go to your C prompt, go to your C drive. Okay, so in C drive, program files. Okay, so now here you can see min.gw64. Okay, in C drive, program files, min.gw64 folder is there. Okay, so double click on this folder, and there is another folder, i686 folder. Double click on this. Okay, now you can see that means there is no GCC support in this. That means the software is not being installed correctly. Okay, so what you need to do is, again you need to install. Okay, so we got an error here. Okay, so we need to reinstall the software again. So what you do is go back to your downloads folder. Downloads folder. Okay, click on this min.gw install.exe software. Okay, so click on yes, then say next, then say next, then next. Wait until it is downloaded correctly. If you have poor internet connection, you may get error like this. Okay, so wait for the software to download and install correctly. So friends, you can watch here. Now the file is being installed correctly. You can see the bar here. Okay, so this green bar growing slowly, that means your file is being installed. wait until this green bar reaches to this end point here. Okay, so then your software will be installed. So friends, once this green bar reaches to the end point, okay, so then you will get a message, click next to continue the installation. Okay, so click on this next button. It takes 10 to 15 minutes to complete this installation. Have some patience. So just clicking on the next button. Okay, so click finish to complete the installation. Okay, so just clicking on the finish button. So this completes finishes installation of MinGW application into your system. Okay, so I told how to check whether it is installed correctly or not. So what you do is go to your C drive. Okay, so go to your C drive. In C drive, users, and in C drive, program files. You need to go to your program files. In that, we have MinGW W64 I686 folder. Click on this. Okay, so in this, now you can see MinGW32 folder. Okay, so you click on this MinGW32 folder. In this, we have bin folder, etc folder. Like this, you have all different folders, and this binary executable files will present in this all applications. Click on this bin folder. Okay, so here you can see GCC application available. That means now this GCC is available in this software. Okay, so where is this GCC? Now this is the path of a GCC. So this path, you copy this path here. Okay, so copy here. I'm just copying C program files, MinGW64 I682, MinGW bin. Okay, so this folder you need to copy. Okay, so copy this folder, and you need to paste this path in your environment variables. Okay, so how to go to your environment variables? Okay, so on my PC, click on properties. Okay, then advanced system settings. Okay, on my computer, right click on my computer. Okay, so right click on my computers and click on this properties. Okay, so then you will get this screen here. Click on advanced system settings. Okay, so here you will have environment variables button. Click on this environment variables button. Okay, and here go to this system variables. Okay, so in system variables we'll have a field called as a path. Okay, this is one path, is one variable, system variable. Okay, so select this path variable. Okay, so then click on edit. Click on edit. Okay, so here you need to paste your path here. Okay, so whatever path we selected, just you paste that path at the beginning. Okay, so move the cursor to the beginning of this path. When you click on this editor, generally the cursor will be at the end of this path. Okay, so now I moved the cursor to the beginning of the path. Now I am pasting this. Okay, so press Control V button. Control V button. Okay, so then you need to type semicolon. That means each path you need to separate by using semicolon here. Okay, so this is the MinGW32/bin, then semicolon followed by remaining path will be as it is. Okay, so don't disturb the previous path variables. Okay, right, so just at the beginning you move the cursor to the at the beginning and paste your this MinGW path here. Okay, so then click on OK, then click on OK here. Okay, so then click on OK here. Okay, so then now I'll go back to our git bash command prompt. Okay, so I am here on git bash command prompt. Okay, so now I type the command once again. Okay, so gcc first.c. Now you can see, friends, your program compiled successfully. This time I won't get any error here. Previously this bash shell has given error that command GCC not found. Okay, so now I did not get any error. That means your program is compiled successfully. Okay, so just you type ls command. Now you can see. Okay, so in Linux, we'll get the exe file name as a.out. Okay, but here in git bash, we get the exe file name as a.exe. We get the file name as a.exe. Okay, so now you execute this a.exe file. Okay, so to execute that exe file, you need to type /a.exe. Okay, so then press enter. Now you can see your program is being executed and you can see the welcome message, welcome to installation of git bash. Okay, so then afterwards you will see the dollar prompt. Okay, so that's how you can start executing your C programs, C++ programs, and other compilers are also supported in that MinGW software. Okay, so mainly students require C and C++ compilers. You can work out C++ programs in Windows environment on bash shell. Okay, so that means you get a feel of working on a Linux environment being in Windows operating system. Okay, friends, this is how we can execute C programs. Okay, so let us see some more commands so that they will be helpful to you. Okay, so I'm clearing the screen, just clear the screen. Okay, so ls, now I have two files in my directory. Okay, so if I want to open the file at the command prompt itself, okay, so then I can use cat command, cat first.c, you can type. Now your program is being displayed on the command prompt itself. Just to view the program, yes, you want to view the program on the command prompt, you can use cat command here, cat space first.c. okay, so you cannot make any changes in this program. If you want to make any changes in this program, what you need to do, again you need to open the vi editor, vi first.c. that means now your program is being opened in the VI editor. Okay, so the first thing you need to do is press the key I. Okay, so the key I you need to press so that this moves to insert mode. Your VI editor changes to insert mode so that you can make changes in your program. Okay, you can make changes in the program. Afterwards, what you do, you need to save your program. So for that, you press escape key. Okay, so once you press escape key, the insert word is gone. Okay, so then type the command colon WQ, then press enter. So you will be redirected to command prompt here. Okay, so just type the clear command there. Okay, so again you can compile and execute your programs. Okay, so this is how you can make changes in the program if there are any errors or you want to make some changes in the program. Okay, so next we'll see one more command. That means I want to copy the same program into another file. So then I can use a command called as cp, cp first.c. Okay, so then I say some ex.c. I want to copy the same program instead of typing again. Okay, so just I want to execute a command so that the entire program is copied into another file. Okay, so now it is successful. You can just type ls command and you can see both the files, first.c and ex.c. Both will be available, both contains the same program. Okay, so just you can see the program on the command prompt itself by typing the cap command, cat ex.c. Now you can see the same program is copied into this file, ex.c. Let me clear the screen. Okay, so sometimes we may give the file name wrongly. Okay, so in such case, you want to just rename the file. You want to rename the file. Okay, so let us show, let us take one example. For example, instead of ex.c, I want to rename this by another name. Okay, so there you can use this move command, move ex.c old file name, and what new name you want to give to this file, that you type here. For example, I want to make it as sample.c. Okay, so now you type ls command, just see here friends. Okay, so ex.c is renamed as a sample.c. If you use copy command, two files will be created, but if you use mv command, the same file name will be renamed to the new name. Okay, so if you want to give a new name to the file, then you can use this mv command. Mv command. So finally, you can check out what is your present working directory. So you are in C users Raju, C programs. Okay, so that's all, friends. Hope you got the feel of working on a bash shell, Linux shell in Windows environment. I have installed the two softwares, JITBASH and MinGW, these two softwares, and you will get a feel of working on Linux command prompt being in Windows. So thank you, friends. Thank you, one and all. If you like this video, do share the video among your friends and click on the like button. And if you are not subscribed, subscribe to my channel immediately. Thank you, one and all.